finally going to go looking for Rorim now?
Seems like a good place to start, Alice. We started to find out more about Rorim at last.
So you think they've been following you for the last thousands of years?
Hundreds? I'm not that old. Well, I think it's hundreds. We're talking Earth years.
Off topic. Why have they been following you?
Not a clue. Maybe not just watching, maybe steering events, guiding people and reshaping history to their own plan.
Ooh, sinister. It could have been used all these years.
Well, it stops now. Well, it stops soon. We've arrived. Come on, let's clear this little mystery up.
Right, so we're on a beach. Are the Order of Rorim coming on holiday here?
I don't know.
Oh, you out of everybody, Doctor, should not be judging by appearances. You time travel in a phone box.
Well, aren't you a smart girl? Come on, Alice.
So his most treasured possession that he could never ever swap was a small mirror, which he swapped for a small mirror.
It's quite poetic, really, isn't it?
Really?
No, that doesn't rhyme, does it? Anyway, look, there's something etched on this mirror. See? Some kind of coordinates.
Like latitude and longitude?
Yes, these are four-dimensional. They're for a specific place, for a specific time.
So, do you think these coordinates could lead you to Rorim?
I think so. Come on, let's get back to the TARDIS.
Right, inside I guess then?
I'm afraid I must only take the Doctor in.
Alice.
You want me to wait here?
Yes. Well, this thing has been watching me. 1600 years it's watched me. And I don't know whether it's been meddling my life or not. This is personal.
But if it's watched you all the time, then it knows you're coming. It might not want to be found.
Yes, I know. And if anything happens to me, the TARDIS will take you back. I promise, Alice. But this, I need to face alone.
Sorry to say something like that. Well, it's been fun, Doctor. Good luck.
Thank you, Alice. Don't worry. I'll be back before you know it.
You better be.
TARDIS will take me home, he says. How? How do you work? Well, I've seen the Doctor do this plenty of times. What are you doing? It must be... this one.
Ah, hello, Alice. How are you? Sorry it took so long. Took a while longer than I hoped. Glad you waited.
Yeah, well, I knew you'd be back.
Yeah, you were trying to work out how to get home, weren't you?
Well, you've been gone ages. Really, the TARDIS needs me to sing to work.
Yeah, I'm afraid so. The old girl really likes the Beatles. I've tried getting her into the Stones, but she's just not having any of it.
Funny that your ship would have the same taste as my granddad.
Good taste is obviously not genetic, my dear.
I'm not taking good taste jokes from a guy wearing that suit.
Yeah, I've heard something along those lines, where something will happen in another universe that hasn't happened into another,
and all things that could happen do happen in some other universe. Like, there could be one where I don't travel with you, or where Simon Cowell decides to work in Sainsbury's and becomes a regional manager and there's no X Factor.
Exactly.
So, after all that?
Nothing's changed. We carry on, Alice.
Travelling through time and space?
Travelling, righting wrongs, fighting evil, annoying people, that sort of thing, Alice. Running around and saving the universe. So what, are you ready?
Always.
Right, marvellous. Onwards.